You are looking at the Domesday Advanced Interactive Video System. It's a major development in the way that we access and use information, a development that every business in the country needs to know about. The heart of the Domesday system is two discs, full of information. The range covered by the information on these discs is quite breathtaking. It's like holding a complete research library in one hand. There are government, economic, employment, and financial statistics. Authoritative statistics of the highest quality that the government itself uses in its planning. Then there are the results of the latest population census, covering over 350 different census items. As well as the facts, there are maps. Ordnance survey maps of the entire country, down to street level for many places. And pictures. Thousands of still pictures and video clips, and text information on life in every part of Britain today. The BBC took responsibility for gathering all this information together, checking and editing to make sure that every item is accurate and as up-to-date as the statistics allow. But it's not just the range of information that's so remarkable about the Domesday system. Equally important is that Domesday is very easy to use. This may come as a surprise, because the first thing you notice about the Domesday system is the high technology. Discs read by laser beam. Information controlled and processed by a microcomputer. But the point of all this high technology is that it looks after the difficult things for you. It interprets your commands from the trackable or the keyboard, finds the information on the disc, displays it on the monitor, changes it in response to your instructions. And because it's so simple, anyone can use Domesday. You don't have to be computer literate. All you need is a thirst for information. Let me give you an example of how it works.
Marketing services, Johnson speaking. Oh, hello, CJ. What can I do for you, sir? Yes? Uh-huh. I see. Right, well, if the board are thinking of expanding into do-it-yourself stores, you're going to need some data on general market size. Yes, and trends, yes, of course. How about related business areas? No problem at all. And when would you like all this? Oh, in a week. I think we can do rather better than that, CJ. How about tomorrow? No, sir, I'm not joking. Just you leave it with me. I'll come right back to you. Right, bye for now.
Right, Domesday, my friend. Here we go.
Spending on DIY. Well, it found DIY and spending. It found a perfect match. So that's an item with both words. Looks promising. All right, let's have a look at them. There's some interesting background. Oh, what's that? I want number 12. Data. Spending on DIY products. I'll have a look at that. Yeah, let's see. This shows spending by product. Product A obviously gets the most. And what's that? Home decorating. What about product B? Self-assembly furniture. That's interesting. Now, what I really need to know is whether spending on DIY is going up or down. I'll change the chart so I get spending by year. And then replot it. There we are. Looks like a healthy growing trend. What was the size of the market in that last year? There it is, at the top. Over £2,000. That should interest the board. I wonder if all parts of the market have grown at the same rate. Let's have a look at home decorating on its own. Yeah, well, that's obviously pretty flat. But it's too big to be ignored. What about that self-assembly furniture? Smaller volume, but much better growth. Looks like an area to go into. I'll produce a copy of that chart for CJ.
And then, later on, I can show the whole sequence to the board tomorrow. Yeah, that should impress them.
Right. Time to get back to CJ, I think.
Hello, CJ. Johnson here, sir. I've got some preliminary figures for you. On the contrary, it's perfectly possible. You see, I've been using our new Domesday system. Haven't you? Well, you should pop into marketing and I'll give you a demonstration. Yes, it is amazing. In fact, quite honestly, I don't know how we ever managed without it.
So that's one way in which the Domesday system can be used. Instant information on an enormous range of subjects which are directly relevant to business use. Information which it could take hours to track down in a library, if you could find it at all. Information which you can display in the way that tells you what you want to know. And for every set of information stored on Domesday, there's a piece of text, which you can also display on the screen, that tells you the source of the data. So, if you want to check out more details, you know exactly where to look. On the strength of Johnson's preliminary findings, the board have decided to go ahead with an initial DIY superstore. CJ, after some excellent tuition from an unsuspecting Johnson, has now taken over at the keyboard.
I think I've just about got the hang of this now, Johnson, don't you?
Now, let's see. Johnson's market research report suggested that the biggest spending on DIY was by people who own their own homes. Information on housing probably comes under society. Yes, there we are. Number four, housing. And I want, housing tenure. And then tenure type. There we are. Number 11. Maps showing owner-occupied housing levels around the country. I'll just pull that up, and here it comes. Now, what do these colours mean? Let's pull up the key. There it is at the top. So red's the highest density. Over 66% of dwellings. I wonder what areas these figures are calculated for. If I select detail, and then areas, I should get it at the top of the screen. There it is. They're for each local government district. That's okay. Now, if we are going to start up this new venture, the board are going to want it to be close to home so they can keep an eye on it. That probably means somewhere in the East Midlands. And there's a lovely red area just round here. I wonder where that is. Ah, Rushcliffe. And this is Hinckley. And that's Rugby. Right, those areas look promising. Next step is to get on the phone and see what sites there are available. Of course, what we've shown you here is a fairly simplified example. In reality, CJ would have gone on to look at a number of other factors. Spending on DIY by region, perhaps? Proportion of leisure time spent on DIY? Age structure of the population? Unemployment levels? Many different factors and types of information that go into shaping a business decision, and all are immediately available from the Domesday system. The information that we've been looking at so far comes from the Domesday's national disk. That's the one that holds statistics and data for the whole country. The other disk, the community disk, describes local communities throughout the United Kingdom. It's the community disk that holds the ordnance survey maps for the whole country. Some 24,000 maps, which by themselves would probably cost more than the entire Domesday system.
Hello? Oh, Tom, at last. Have you finished that delivery in Peterborough yet? You have. Right, well, listen, get your skates on and get back here sharpish. We've got a... What? Oh, they do they? Well, how urgent is this special delivery? Oh, it's that urgent, is it? Right, well, you better tell him to do it. Hang on, I'll get your quote. Where's it got to go to? Steeple what? Steeple Bumpstead? Where on earth, Steeple Bumpstead? No, you wouldn't, would you? Hang on, how do you spell it? Yeah. Right. Okay, then hang on, I'll get on the Domesday. Right. My old darling, find this needle in an haystack for me, will you?
Got it. Now let's zoom out to see where you're near to.
Oh, yes, over near Newmarket.
So, if Tommy's coming down from Peterborough, he'll want to get onto the A1. And then the 604. Right, I'll just measure that up. That's 29.5 kilometres. Hold on, what's that in real distances? 18 miles. That's better. Then, going from there to there makes a total of 30. So that's 50 miles altogether.
Hello, Tommy. It works out at just about 50 miles, right? So you can tell him it's going to cost him between 30 and 40 quid. Okay? Good lad. Now, this is the best way to get there.
And Tommy can be given exact instructions to the place he wants in minutes. But that's not all the Domesday maps can do for you. They can help you measure areas, too. And in major towns, the maps go right down to street level. Every small-scale map has a number of pictures and pieces of text associated with it, and these can provide a wealth of valuable information about the locality.
Good morning, sir. Welcome to Specialist Holidays. My name is James Campbell, and you are...
Hiram C. McGregor III.
Hiram C. McGregor III. I see, sir. And what particular kind of holiday might we interest you in, sir?
Golf, sir. I want to play some golf.
I see.
But Mrs. McGregor doesn't play the game. She wants to look at castles. Yes, do you have any good castles around the place?
Right. Well, we have some of the finest golf courses in the world in Scotland, sir. And I'm sure we can find some castles to keep Mrs. McGregor entertained.
If you care to look at the screen, Mr. McGregor, I'd like to show you some locations that I think might interest you.
Is that an American gadget, sir?
Excuse me?
Yeah, I saw one of those things last year in Kansas City.
No, sir, I don't think you'd have seen anything quite like this in Kansas City. You see, the Domesday system was developed here in Britain.
No, sir, any golfer visiting Scotland must start at St. Andrews. And here is the golf course. I can show you some lovely pictures of the area. And the town. And, of course, the golf course itself. Now, sir, moving further down the coast, we have another very fine links here at Balcombe. And here we have a picture of the course. And here is the nearby Kelly Castle. I can show you some information about the castle.
Now, does this seem to be the sort of location you'd be interested in, sir? Excellent. Well, I'll prepare some schedules with details of hotels, golf course facilities, and so on.
Listen, Campbell, skip the whole thing. Just send me a Domesday with a hotel.
Yes, Mr. McGregor, I suppose you could just stay home and look at Domesday. But I'm afraid the only thing it couldn't do, sir, is give you a decent game of golf.
So that's the Domesday system. An astonishing collection of data, statistics, maps, pictures, and text on hundreds of different subjects. Almost anyone in any business can use Domesday to make their work easier and more efficient. If you're in market research, Domesday can give you population statistics and consumption trends and help you identify target audiences. If you're in personnel, it can show you where to find skilled labor. If you're in property, it can help you find sites and even measure them. And if you're in distribution, it can help you plan detailed routes more quickly and efficiently than ever before. For large organizations, Domesday offers a way of checking out ideas and possibilities quickly and cheaply without carrying out expensive research. For small companies, Domesday is a reference library on a desktop, a cost-effective planning and marketing tool that provides information which, without Domesday, most companies just couldn't afford. And Domesday provides all this, a comprehensive business library, a rapid access desktop research tool, a four-tier mapping and plotting system, a business presentation system, even a fascinating diversion for your staff and visitors. at a fraction of the cost from any other source.